Right, Aki Kareem, British boxers, we're down here in Denton today at Robert Rimmer's Phoenix camp. We've got with us Mr. Mark Keffer and Mr. Robert Rimmer. Boys, good to see you today. Obviously, we haven't caught up since the fight with Liam Williams, so, you know, a lot of people have been asking me, you know, how's Mark, how's Rob getting on since the fight? So, let's just get straight into it. Mark, I'll start with you. Obviously, first professional loss. I'll just leave it to you to do the talking, mate. How are you feeling after the fight?
Yeah, I'm feeling good. I'm buzzing back in the gym now, Robert. Training, working on, obviously, the things that I did wrong on the night. And yeah, just, like, perfect problems from the night, yeah.
You said to me just there off the camera that, you know, you expected to be a bit more disappointed, but you've sort of taken it in your stride. You've sort of put it down to the fact that it is what it is sort of thing.
Yeah, definitely. It is what it is. It was a massive night, yeah, and I proper enjoyed it. I think the night like took over a bit, man, and that's what took it out of me.
When you say took, what do you mean, sort of the atmosphere and
the atmosphere and that. It's like Liam said about the experience. I've experienced that now, and I think next time I will definitely be better next time.
Fair enough. Rob, obviously a disappointing night for you. I know going into the fight you were very, very confident. I mean, what do you think sort of went wrong, you know, in the fight?
Do you know what? The preparations all went perfect. I'm just like saying it's a cliche, it did go perfect. You know, Mark had some really, you know, world-class sparring and he was firing. But, I mean, look, this was a big occasion, a massive occasion, not only for him, for me as well. But going in there on the night, he had a lot to deal with, a lot of pressures. Liam Williams, he's you know, he's a world-class fighter. I rated him before, said that to him, I rate him after. You know, and we knew that, you know, it was going to be a tough, tough fight. But, like I said, going into it, sometimes, as a fighter, as a coach, as whatever, you know, you've got to gain experience. All the fighters, all these top people have gone to the top, have all had to go through experiences, whether it be good or whether it be bad. But Mark had a lot to deal with that night, and sometimes you take it and you thrive off it, and sometimes it just doesn't quite go your way, it doesn't happen for you, but he just couldn't get into a rhythm. There was just nothing there. It was visual, you could see he was very slow, he wasn't in range. Nothing was registering. Liam boxed to his game plan and it worked. But you know, there's an argument, you know, did Mark make him look better than what he was? Or, you know, did Mark underperform, or did he outbox and outclass Mark? You know, there's an argument for all three. But I just think if that fight was to happen again in 12 months' time, it would be a whole different fight. But again, he's come away with a massive, massive experiences from it. You know, leading up to the fight, press conferences, and just the whole occasion of being in there. And you know what, he's took it well, you know. And so why, it's a massive learning curve. It took a long time to come round from it. But it's, you know, it hurts, you know what I mean, it hurts. But if it didn't, then I'd be in the wrong game. So, you know, took a lot from it going forward. And hopefully, you know, this year, it'll be a good year, big year, yeah.
I mean, Mark, you said to me, you know, a bit earlier, I mean, you mentioned that you thought the fight may have come just a tiny bit early, but you know, you're willing to step up, which obviously you get a lot of respect for stepping up, but what did you mean by that in terms of you thought it may have come a little bit early for you?
Well, when Kevin rang me about the fight, obviously, I'm not going to back down from anyone, but I said to Kev, like, I felt like it was a bit of a step too far, like, for me, like, at that time. Obviously, I'm not going to say no to the fight, but then I left it to Kevin, you know what I mean? And Kevin said that he was, like, people were ready to fight him. So that's why the fight got major.
In terms of the actual fight, obviously, you got in the ring and you sort of, you weren't your normal self, so to speak, and you know, you said that to me. Like, what was going on in the actual ring? I mean, what, you know, when you look back at it, did you sort of kick yourself and think I should have done that?
I've watched it back now. There's loads of things that I've been like, wow, like I just looked slow. My foot looked slow. Everything just went wrong. Should have went right. Went wrong.
Go on. What are you
saying? No, saying nothing clicked. It was a little bit like, I don't know, like. From the outside looking, he kind of froze. He wasn't his own self, like Mark's. Everyone that knows him, he's sharp, he's explosive. You know, when he smells blood, he's on you. That's the type of fighter he is. And it's, you know, everybody knows that. And when you talk about stepping up, and again, Liam Williams, you know, he's at that level. You watch the way he progressed, you watch what he's done, and you can go on about Beam's opponents and this and that, but you know what he's doing in the gym, what he's doing when he's going sparring. I know sparring, fighting, but he's shouting out all the right things. So when these big fights come around on these big occasions, you think, well, you know, he is ready. you know, he is ready because, you know, he's not just holding his own, he's dominating, you know what I mean, when in certain spars. So sometimes you've got to kind of take risks, but now, in any sport, you kind of find your level.
Yeah.
But it's, you know, he's gone in there with someone who is ready to go for world honors, and rightly so. And, you know, he gains a lot from that experience because it gives you a benchmark. And it's not just a benchmark about where you are, you know, talent-wise, but again, it's that experience that comes with it, how to handle it. What can you do right, what can you do wrong? You know, it's the build up to it, and on the occasion, how to handle that situation. And then you find that you're ready. Obviously, you know, Mark, you know, not saying he's not ready, but at least now he knows what it feels like. You know what I mean? So we can take our time again, he's young, and then we can start to rebuild. And look, 2019, as long as he stays busy, these big fights are going to come again, you know what I mean? But the next time, what we want to do is make sure that he's 100% right physically and mentally going into them big fights.
Mm-hmm. You mentioned, Mark, that you've already got your sort of next date locked in. You're fighting at Oldham, back in your own town, headlining the bill. I know you do hell of a load of tickets in Oldham. You're looking at a six rounder there, is it, I believe?
Yeah, six rounder.
And then you're looking to potentially build on to an eight rounder next, just to get back in the flow of things.
Yeah, just I want two decent fights that we can get the good round in, just get used to being out there in the arena. It's not really the same as sparring in the gym, like, it's a different feeling, you know, when you're in that arena. I'm going to get used to it all properly, yeah, and then next time I go for the British, I'll be more than ready.
Do you feel like this is like a turning point for you in terms of like your mentality and the way you're going to approach your career in the future? Do you really feel like it's going to give you that settlement and sort of spur you on a bit more?
Yeah, 100%, because I've been in there now and I've done it, and I know what it takes now for the next time, and yeah, I'm just kind of looking forward to the next one now.
Yeah, the massive thing as well, you know, because now for him, well, the kind of the same, like the monkey's off his back. Yeah. You know, he's got that big undefeated record, known as a massive puncher. All these things that come along with, you know, with being, you know, having that record, that he's got, massive ticket seller. You know, he sells, but that pressure's gone now.
Mm.
You know, that pressure's gone, and yeah, he's lost, but he's lost to a class fighter.
Yeah.
Class fighter.
Yeah.
So you can go one or two ways. You can let it defeat you and you walk away from it and that's it, or you can kind of look at it, take it on the chin, you know, put all them wrongs right. And what he's done is, listen, I've not been able to watch that fight back yet, I'll be honest with you.
Mm-hmm.
He said to me that he's watched it back two or three times, I've not watched it back.
Yeah.
I will do, but listen, it hurt.
It's a bit raw at the minute, yeah, to watch it back.
Listen, we put a lot of time and effort into it, and I genuinely believe that, you know, from watching him, listen, Mark was going to do a number on him, you know what I mean? But all credit to Liam Williams, you know, they done what they done, and Dom got it right, and, you know, he's very experienced, so you got to take your hat off to him. But again, well, we take a lot of positives away from it,
yeah.
You know what I mean? So.
And yeah, as you, I'm glad you said that, because Liam Williams himself did box a really good fight, didn't he?
Yeah.
And, you
perfect.
Know, I was worried at the end, you know, because the build-up started to get a bit nasty towards the end of the build-up, even though I know you and Liam have gone back a long
year.
But, you know, afterwards you was in each other's dressing room and you was chatting, and that was a nice sight to see as well. Have you spoke to him since, or?
Yes. Well, he texted me the other week to see how it was on that, and to my phone, texted me, seeing how it was on that, so yeah, and I texted him back, so yeah, I'm good on that, yeah. Getting back in the gym now. I was getting back in the gym then. And just got to move on now, innit? And put it behind me. Get back in there, 16th of March.
16th of March, that's the date there in Oldham. And just one last question, Rob, obviously about, you know, as a trainer, rebuild, you know, when you've got to rebuild a fighter, you know, it's not just about rebuilding the fighter physically, it's about rebuilding the fighter confidence-wise, mentally-wise.
Of course.
And often I see fighters who've lost a big fight and they're a lot more reserved than Mark's been. This is, as you know, I've just been speaking to Mark there, and he seems completely fine in himself, but there's obviously things you've got to build back into a fighter psychologically as well, isn't there?
100%, yeah, and every one of them are different individuals, and I've got seven fighters, and every one of them, you know, individually, you've got to kind of, you know, you've got to work each one out, but everyone takes a little bit different than others. Now, look, it's a sport, and, you know, even if the best of them, you know, I mean, look at Rocky Fielding, perfect example. You know, get stopped in the first round of Callum Smith. But where he is now, you know what I mean? He's gone on to the biggest occasion ever, you know. You just never know what's around the corner, but you know what? He still believes in himself, and he's got them opportunities. And look at him now, you know, he's financially well off, everything's come out. You know, he's done everything you need to do in the sport. Yeah, he got beat off, you know, one of probably the, arguably the best in the sport, but what I'm saying is, you know, Charlie Edwards, another one. you know, come back. These these little setbacks.
Crawler from back
Crawler,
in the
perfect, league. Yeah, Crawler, you know what I mean? And little setbacks make way for massive comebacks, but again, it's all learning. And even for me, like I said, I've been around this sport for years, and I've always going to be under the shadow of my dad, because my dad's been in it for a long, long time. But listen, I took my own way 3 years ago, and as a trainer, I've gone my own way with my own ways in 3 years. Listen, I'm proud of myself now, and I've come a long way in 3 years. I've got a good stable of fighters, you know, I've had a Commonwealth title. And I just think to myself, you know what, all this is experience, it's all learning. And, you know, I look at all these top coaches, you know, and I respect them massively, Adam Booth, Dominic King, you know, all of that, you know, there's loads out there. And I think, well, 10 more years, you know, where I've got goals, where am I going to be? But, you know, I've got a great camp, great set of lads. So it's all, again, it's all learning, you know what I mean? And we're going in one direction, and that's up. So, can't wait.
Fair enough. And Mark, obviously, final word goes to you, mate. I know you've got, you know, obviously you've got this fight date set up, but what do you want to say to all the people that sort of supported you for that, for the Liam Williams fight, and will and carry on supporting you?
Yeah, the support for the Liam Williams fight was amazing. So thank you to everyone that came down that night and supported me. And I've had so many messages about the Oldham show as well on the 16th of March. So I just want to say thank you to everyone that's got for consistent support, and thanks to all my sponsors, yeah.
All right, boys, appreciate the time. Cheers, and look forward to the next fight now.
Cheers, mate. Thank you.
Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed that video, leave your comments below. We love hearing your opinion, and also remember to hit that subscribe button. See you next time.